Well, into every life, a little rain must fall. I brought in the telescope from outside about half an hour ago. The clouds had been coming in, and I'm afraid that there's just not gonna be good viewing tonight. I have discovered a number of challenges. Now, the way it is over there now, it's perfectly horizontal, but when it looks up at the sky, you have to get down underneath it to look through the finder scope. Even if it is, if the legs extend a little bit on the tripod and raise it up this high, you still got the viewfinder down only about 4 feet off the ground. And it just really aches my back to get down there and try to look in through the star-finding scope. Now, the main observing lens has a star prism that takes it and bends it 90 degrees, so I don't have to bend over quite so much. But I need to find myself some kind of very low, sturdy footstool that I can get way down, like 2 or 3 feet above the ground. At the worst, when the scope is pointing straight up, there's only like 3 feet between the finding scope and the ground, so I have to be able to get down, and I have to be able to be still. Now, I also need a seat to sit on when I look through the main lens, so some sort of step stool with steps lower, medium, and higher may be the solution. Now, we have one of those here in the house that people used to use to get up into the upper cabinets because they weren't 6 feet tall like I am. I can reach up to the highest cabinet in the kitchen, but my stepfather was only 5 foot tall, and my mother is only 5 foot tall, so they always use the steps. And so I may be able to use that, but of course I can't just take a chair out there because I weigh over 300 pounds and the chair will break if I sit on it very long. So it has to be something sturdy. Now, I've got some good solid chairs that I use to sit on, but they're not quite low enough for the lowest that I have to go down to. So a step stool and the lowest tread, only a foot off the ground, and the next tread 2 feet, and the third tread 3 feet, is probably going to be the solution. But that was not the problem tonight, because I couldn't even spend much time looking. And what I was looking at, it wasn't straight up, it was like this angle, so I could get down and look through the finder scope, but the clouds were coming in. And besides that, it's in the city. And besides that, I'm still learning how to drive that thing, that beautiful instrument I have now. And it's It's a real challenge. But I am slowly answering the challenge. I knew it would be difficult because I've had a telescope before, not as fine and not as big as this one is, but I did have one. I bought it for the eclipse of the moon, basically, back in around 1992. So that was 25 years ago, when I was only 42 years old. And I was going to buy one of these, not this big a one, but one about half that size. And I'd been to the telescope store at the downtown shopping mall, the rebuilt part of downtown San Diego in the late 80s. They built this whole new shopping mall downtown. And that one of the stores was a telescope store. And those were the years when I was working at City Hall. All told, about 20 years I worked downtown, and then another 10 or 15 years in different parts of the city, and also a couple of years I worked for the county government, and about 5 years also in retail sales through my working period before I ran away to Mexico and developed the job I now have, which is a translator. But I'm only doing that part-time now. My expenses are very, very low. And anyhow, this telescope was a big, big investment for me. And I have to look at it and realize, God willing, I may have a few more years of life to look through it. So even though it's been cloudy and raining in the last week since I got it, and tonight was going to be 36% clouds, and unfortunately they decided to come in early. Anyhow, these challenges are, they give a certain flavor, a flavor of challenge to life. I'm not just sitting here twiddling my thumbs every night looking at the internet. I'm writing, and I do have a translation project I'm working on right now, and I was hoping to get some seeing in, and I did get some measuring of the sky with the telescope and star finding, and but then the clouds came in before I really could settle down, and within the next month, Jupiter will be in a fine position to be viewed, because we will be at a position that's called opposition. Jupiter and the Sun will be at opposite sides, and the Earth will be between them. So we will be about as close to Jupiter as we ever come. Every 13 months we pass by close to Jupiter, and the distance from the Sun to the Earth is called one astronomical unit. It's about 90 million miles, 8 minutes in light. And then the distance from the Earth to Jupiter, when it's at its closest, is a little over 4 astronomical units, which is about half an hour of light. So it takes 40-some minutes for the light to go from the Sun out to Jupiter. Then it bounces off Jupiter and comes back to the Earth, and we see it. 40 minutes from the Sun to Jupiter, and then 30 minutes back to the Earth. And that will be when Jupiter's at its closest. And with my most powerful lens, Jupiter will look about that big held at arm's length. And I'll be able, I hope, to see the bands and the red spot if that side of Jupiter is turned towards us, and the brighter moons that go around Jupiter. Io, Ganymede. I forget their names. I don't know very much. I'm really realizing that I am an amateur astronomer. It's one thing to read in books, and it's another thing to have an instrument like that over there and try to drive it through the universe. So, that is my disappointment that I couldn't have but 10 or 15 minutes of viewing time before the clouds came in. And my challenge is of getting a seat that I can seat myself on and be comfortable for long periods of time. And waiting for the storm clouds to pass. So, that is the news from my little observation deck above Freeway Valley. And I think with that, I will just say good night and see you next time.